Everyone in the building industry is having to contend more and more with the new EPB directives. One way of complying with these regulations is to make buildings airtight. So this is something architects need to factor in during the initial stages of their projects.
EPB stands for the Energy Performance of Buildings. The aim is to use the energy available as rationally as possible. As energy is a finite resource, we have to use it sparingly. There are two key factors involved in energy-efficient building. First of all, the techniques we use have to be as cost-effective as possible. These include heating system and ventilation units. However, the building itself, the shell, also plays a key role. A number of important items are to be found in the shell of a building, as this carcass is, after all, the place where we carry out our activities. The insulation is generally what comes to mind when we think about the shell. The insulation is one highly significant factor. A second and equally important factor is airtightness. This can be expressed in human terms. When you go out for a walk, you put on a woolen pullover, but if the day is windy, the wind will pass through your pullover, so you will not feel very warm. It is equally important for you to wear a decent coat to stop the air passing through. A building's airtightness plays a key role in terms of the E-points you are awarded. Under the EPB system, you are required to supply various pieces of information, whereupon you are graded according to how well you perform, a bit like when you were at school. You have to achieve a good score, and this means your building has to be very airtight. As for how this can be achieved, the various parts of the building and all the joints are important considerations within this context. This means the joints between the walls and floors, the windows and the walls, the joint between the glass and the frame are all just as important. All the joints, therefore, have to be of the same quality. In EPB terms, this is measured by the number of air movements per hour and according to the size of the building envelope in square meters. If no action is taken, the score is 12. A well-thought-out design merits 9. A well-thought-out design with airtight flashes and effective seals for the shell earns you a factor 2. Passive buildings may even achieve a score of 0.15. Energy savings are amazing when you compare a standard layout with one that is carefully thought out. This represents a saving of 10 to 15 points, which is quite substantial. Just as important is the installation method. The theory is all very well, but it is obviously a bit more complicated in practice. It is important for the flashing to be applied carefully and accurately with a great attention to detail. It is of course crucial to be able to rely on the solid support of a supplier in this case.
Airtight sealing is obviously set to become a key issue in the future. Once a decision has been taken to opt for an airtight building structure, it's absolutely essential to choose a reliable partner. Buret System is playing a pioneering role in furthering the cause of new airtight construction techniques.
Buret System is a Belgian manufacturer of doors and windows and has been aware for years now of the progress being made in getting energy under control in the window manufacturing sector. Increasingly important are the improvements being made to the performance of sections, glass, and the energy-efficient placing of doors and windows. This includes energy efficiency and airtightness for the joinery component of facades. In view of the huge changes in recent years and increasingly strict standards looming up on the horizon, we are obliged to provide training to our network of retailers on a constant basis. Towards this end, we are able to count on the DL Chemical support services.
Once the building concept has been decided upon and a partner picked for the joinery activities, the next stage involves the actual job of installing the joinery. Paraband W interior and exterior have self-adhesive strips with which they are attached around the frame. It's essential to provide enough material by creating a loop in the corners in order to guarantee the best possible seal with the wall and masonry. The tapes are followed by the anchors, which have to be placed behind the paraband W. The strips have to be wide enough so the anchors are completely behind. On the outside of the window, a sealing tape is attached for the joint between window and wall. Two separate paraband W parts may be placed, provided there is enough overlapping to ensure the seal is perfectly airtight. Once the paraband W and anchors have been placed, the next thing is to place and fix the frame. The window wall joint is then filled with flexible PU foam, Parafoam Flexible. The foaming process and the removal of any excess foam is followed by gluing the paraband W to the masonry with Parabond construction. It's important for the paraband W to follow the angles as closely as possible to avoid any subsequent plastering problems. It's best to use two continuous linear strips in this case, so as to create a perfect airtight joint. The strips need to be firmly pressed in the Parabond construction in order to create a perfect seal, while the angles are correctly finished with extra Parabond construction. A blower door test is undertaken to detect any remaining leaks. After all the windows and doors have been sealed, a modular component is placed in a door opening with one or two blowers, according to the volume of the building to be inspected. The blowers produce 50 Pascal of negative or positive pressure. A visual smoke detection test can be used for detecting leaks. The outdoor seals are checked with a smoke machine. Indoors, it's easy to see where the smoke, and therefore the air, can enter the building, hence where there is a leak. Another method is to check with an infrared camera, so as to obtain a very precise picture of locations where cold air is entering.
In the final analysis, an airtight joint can be achieved with a small number of products. The DL Chemicals range features a number of products designed for this purpose. First of all, the Paraband W sealing tapes, which are available in two versions, the red-coloured Paraband W interior and the white-coloured Paraband W exterior. Very often, solely the Paraband W interior is used because a cavity is still worked with to a large extent in Belgium.
Omdat in België nog altijd veel gebruik wordt gemaakt van een spouw. Een tweede product in ons.
A second product in our system for airtight structures is the PU foam. Parafoam Flexible. This one component, elastic PU foam, perfectly catches all joint movements from the surrounding materials, so the foam does not crack. It has to be applied into the hollow space behind the sealing strip between the window and the wall. A third product is our adhesive sealant Parabond construction. This ready-to-use elastic adhesive sealant serves two purposes within our system for airtight structures. This permanently high elastic, hybrid, polymer-based product is used to glue sealing tapes to masonry and for the outer finish between the window and the wall. This is why there is such a wide variety of colors. Lastly, for the finishing touches, we have developed Paracryl, an acrylic sealant for finishing the inner joint between the window and the wall. Once it is hard, the sealant can be painted without any problem. As you can see, airtight seals can be made between the window and walls with a small number of products.